So can someone tell me what you think that this roadmap is?
Explaining
one of
the chapters, like what Mark's about.
Exactly, and just basically what we're going to be talking about today. So if you all haven't noticed, I can be fairly disorganized. And so I have this little roadmap. If you notice, I don't write it on the board one day for SI session, then remind me and tell me, hey, Lincoln, where's the roadmap? Because this will be something that can keep us all organized. This is our goals for the SI session. And by the end of this hour, if all goes well, this will be all the stuff that you guys will know, which is awesome, right? This is a lot of information. So are we ready to learn a little bit more about Mark?
Yeah.
That's the reaction I want to see. So before we get too engrossed in this, you all just tell me a little bit of what you know about Mark. What do you know, Kate?
When the soldiers mocked Jesus and John the Baptist, like when there was baptism, and they went and talked about how Jesus was killed. And
yeah, you're exactly right. Does anyone else want to help contribute to that? That was a really good point.
It was the first gospel.
It was the very first gospel, right? Anything else about Mark?
He is part of the Synoptic Gospels.
Absolutely, it was part of the Synoptic Gospels. Does that word ring a bell for anyone? What is a Synoptic Gospel? Matthew, Mark, and Luke. You're exactly right. And why are they called Synoptic? Ground the points if you know what the word means. Woohoo! I should bring candy or something. You guys are so good. So, like, physical grounding points. You get physical groundings. But you're exactly right. Sing together. And what does that mean, sing together? What does that mean, sing? You're right. They almost quote each other sometimes, as their gospels do. And it makes sense because Mark is the oldest. So it makes sense that Matthew and Luke, which come later, would quote from Mark. One comparison that I've used before students is that whenever you're writing a research paper or anything, you're going to quote from someone else. You're going to quote from a book, or you're going to quote from some other scholarly source, right? You know? So if you think about it, that's kind of what Matthew and Luke are doing. They're quoting from Mark, because Mark has already been written. And actually, let's talk a little bit about, when do you think Mark was written? What are some guesses? 70. Good. Any other guesses?
About 40 years after Jesus' death.
You're right. So it's written probably about the 60s or the 70s. That's the general time period that you get for it. If I'm wrong, please correct me, but I think that's right. And so at this point, you're between 30 and 40 years after Jesus has died. And so what are some of the problems with that? That this is so far after Jesus has been crucified. What does that say about the potential reliability of this account? That this is written so far after the actual events happened?
Some of the stories have changed.
Absolutely right. So if there's something you need to remember that stories change over time. Who was here whenever we played that telephone game during the first SI session? What did you guys notice as that message went around to multiple people around the room? It changed a lot, didn't it? The original message changed to something completely different after it went around to everyone. And so that's something you have here. But think about that telephone game happening over 30 or 40 years. Imagine how different maybe that then. So that's just something to keep in mind about all of these gospels. That, you know, we have to kind of take it with a little grain of salt and realize that each of the authors of the gospels has his or her own motive for writing. They have their own purpose for writing, and they have their own take of events. And we'll see that especially with Matthew. And with Luke and John as well. each of them kind of has their own side of the story, so to speak. Okay?
Do they think Mark was written before the temple was destroyed?
Very good question. The temple was destroyed in, is it 70? Yeah. It would have been written at around that time period. And one thing that you'll see come up in Mark is you'll see this theme of persecution, or you'll see this theme of being, which we'll get to a little bit later, of a suffering servant. You know, what is a good Christian? A good Christian is someone who takes up his cross and who is willing to be persecuted for it. And so if you think about that time period around this year 70, that's where you have the Emperor Nero, who's implementing some of the first statewide persecution of Christians. That's when you have Christians being killed for their beliefs, being imprisoned for their beliefs. And so it kind of makes sense that these things would go along the same time. I'm not sure exactly if it happens before or right after, but it's in that general time period. Really good observation, Sam. Okay, so if you guys are okay with this, if you could get into either one group or two different groups, and if you guys could talk a little bit about who you think may have written Mark. It doesn't have to be specific. It doesn't have to be anything that's even really authentic. You guys can just have your own theories. Pretending that you're writing for National Geographic, and you guys have the next big story. You guys are saying, hey, we believe this is the person who wrote Mark. Okay? So I'll give you all 3 or so minutes to discuss that together. My theory is what we will read right here. Are you guys okay with popcorn reading? But have you guys ever heard of popcorn reading before? Popcorn reading, that's cool. Yeah, as soon as I say you guys, be like, oh, I just know about everything. It's where I look at girls' names and we kind of take turns reading. Okay? Is everyone feel comfortable with that? Okay. So here we go. If you all have not heard of Bible Gateway before, I love it. It's an online resource. It's completely free, and it's an online collection from Bible translations. So you can look up any Bible verse you want. If you want to try out a new translation of the Bible, they have pretty much everything. So it's pretty neat. Okay, so let's start at verse 5, and let's read until verse 15, okay? So I'll go ahead and start, and then I will call on someone else. And then they'll call on someone else, and then they'll call on someone else, until we get all the bed. Okay? So, Peter was therefore kept in prison, but constant prayer was offered to God for him by the church. So who is Peter? Do you guys remember who Peter is?
He's
one of the 12 disciples that hung around with Jesus whenever Jesus was alive. So this is happening, it's Acts, it's happening after Jesus has been killed, and the disciples are being persecuted. You know, they're being imprisoned for following Jesus. So, and when Herod was about to get him out that night, Peter was sleeping, bound with two chains between two soldiers, and the guards before the door were keeping the prison. Now behold, an angel of the Lord stood by him, and a light shone in the prison, and he struck Peter on the side. Jessica.
And raised him up, saying, arise quickly, and his chains fell off his hands. Then the angel said to him, gird yourself and tie on your sandals. And so he did. And he said to him, put on your garment and follow me. So he went out and followed him, and did not know what was done by the angel. He did not know that what was done by the angel was real, but thought he was seeing a vision.
can choose someone else, or you can keep going. It's your choice.
When Peter had come to himself, he said, "Now I know for certain that the Lord has sent his angel and has delivered me from the hand of Herod and from all expectation of the Jews people." So he had considered this. He came to the house of Mary, the mother of John, whose surname was Mark, where many were gathered together praying, saying,
"And is Peter knocked?"
Sorry. No, you go ahead. I'm just highlighting that.
"And is Peter knocked at the door of the gate? A girl named Rhoda came to answer. When she recognized Peter's voice because of her gladness, she did not open the gate, but ran in and announced that Peter stood before the gate.
But they said to her, 'You are beside yourself.' Yet she kept insisting that it was so. So they said, 'It is his angel.'"
Oh my goodness gracious. So, as you can tell, this is a pretty exciting event here. So can someone just tell me in one or two sentences what this event is? What happened here? This is after Jesus has died, and so Acts actually happens right after the Apostles, right after the Gospels. And so you can see here that Peter, who's one of the 12 disciples, has been put into prison. And not only just put in prison, tell me a little bit about how he's kept in prison. Does it look like it's a pretty good situation for him? What's that? You're right about it. But who was he chained between, Jordan? Two soldiers, right? Yeah, and into the wall. So if you think about it, it's almost like he's in max security. You know, he's like a pretty big level prisoner for them now. And so you get an idea this is a really dire situation for him. Like, it doesn't look like he's going to get out alive. But what happens to Peter? He's free. Who by? Yeah, an angel. So an angel comes and an angel releases his chains and he just walks free. And so we get this idea that he's in Jerusalem right now. And so where does he go after he's free? The house of Mary. Absolutely. And so there was another name that was mentioned here. Her son. Who's her son? John Mark. You're exactly right. And so that's my theory of authorship. And a theory that you'll probably be reading about as well. While scholars cannot be completely sure, they believe that the Gospel of Mark may have been written by John Mark. John Mark, who, you guys are right, was an interpreter or a follower of Peter. And so let's think back to if I was asking myself this thought question about the authorship of Mark, and I was saying, well, how would he know all this stuff that he writes about? How might he know some of this stuff if he's so close to Peter? Absolutely. Have your parents or some of your friends ever told you stories about things they've done? And so even if you weren't there, you feel like you know the story just as well as they do because they told you about it. So if you think about it, maybe if he is this person, if he's John Mark, and if he's really good buddies with Peter, maybe his story is fairly reliable, because maybe he's hearing the story from Peter, who's a first-hand witness to the whole entire thing. So let's go ahead and review that first point here. So what's the date, Buckmark?
70.
Yeah, you're right. So I think 70 is probably a better answer for that than authorship. John Mark. And one interesting thing that I want to mention about Mary is in this time period, was Roman and Hebrew society very fair to women? Would I be able to stand up here in pants and be talking to you all in an academic setting, being able to read? Probably not. You're exactly right. And so what do you think it says that